So what is significant about the today's topic will be that what is the use of the most ancient things today? We are in a modern world, and India talks about all ancient things, which has very little relevance. But you must know that in Africa itself, in business schools and colleges and universities, they are using Bhagavad Gita as their manual for management. This is something interesting. And not only that, some people say that Patanjali Yoga Sutra is more popular in America because it is also being used as a manual for management. Kautilya's Arthashastra is known throughout the world that it is a book on management or control system. So, comparing, taking that thread, now we'll tell something today. First, this will be applicable to any branch of knowledge, or should be applicable to any branch of knowledge. Any discipline, any scientific pursuit, or any kind of experimental or experiential aspects. So we'll start first with what is called jnana. Jnana is knowledge. And knowledge of what? For scientists, his knowledge will be something related to scientific reality. For IT people, that knowledge will be related to a kind of information technology. For a lawyer, it will be related to law. His reality is law. Scientist's reality is scientific reality. Lawyer's reality is legal reality. Religion's reality is religious reality. And that reality needs to be realized. When we say the word realization, it means you have something in your mind as real, or you have some goal, and that is called reality. And that you want to make realize means you want to have experience of it. That is realization. We have the word tattva jnana. Tattva, tat means that reality. And tattva means that which is coming to us in the form of knowledge. So tattva means literally speaking thatness. Thatness. Just as we say gentlemanliness or whatever is that, less-ness. Sweetness or bitterness. So that indicates that essential factor, essential nucleus, essential reality, that is called tattva. And when you use the word tva in Sanskrit, it is related to genesis, genus. Tattva indicates genus. So genus means which will give rise to any sorts of species. As in botanists we say genus and species. So it is a generative source. So it is the reality, means that which is the source for all sorts of knowledges, whatever you want to have. And that is called realization. This realization has two aspects. One is individual realization. For example, Einstein realized what is relativity. He had a glimpse of relativity, and therefore he propagated what we call general relativity or special relativity. So, but what it means that he realized that reality, and therefore he experiences it, and that experience is called reality. So that real experience is that then he has realized what is relativity. But he himself has realized it. Nobody has given to him. So it is self bias, his self effort, self thought experience or thought experiments, he got that knowledge of reality. But it could be possible that after, but nobody could get it except Einstein. But he gave it to somebody else. Then he also realized it. But it was not directly, indirectly. It is through Einstein that he got realization. So that is, that time it is called revelation. Realization is, means you have your own experiments, you have your own experience and your own expressions. And it is you who got it. So you learnt it, and it is with your own efforts you got it. Therefore it is called self-realization. But after Einstein, I also learnt relativity. But through someone who knows relativity. Therefore, Maya is called revelation, not realization. It is self-revelation. Somebody has revealed it to me. It didn't reveal to myself. So it is secondary, therefore it is passive. While Einstein's relativity, reality is active. So that passive realization is called revelation. We have parallel that Ramakrishna said, if we believe in that he realized what is Goddess. So he himself realized it. But he also touched Vivekananda and he also realized it. So it was revelation on the part of Vivekananda. Well, it was with self-effort, it was realization for Ramakrishna. So this is all the same case in all disciplines. So realization, self-realization and self-relation, revelation, these are two things. But extension of that is something more. Einstein went ahead and it is in a way he tried to apply his individual relativity to cosmic level. It means he also realized that relativity, reality, not only individual, but also not only people, but cosmic realization. In other words, Einstein had cosmic realization of his own relativity, and that is his reality. So this reality now, this is called cosmic realization. Nobody helped him, he himself did that. But he passed on that knowledge to his student, to his friends, and to his other disciples. Then they also had that knowledge. So they also had cosmic realization, but in fact it was revelation. Because through Einstein they got it. So individual is called self-realization, individual is called self-revelation, and on higher level it is called cosmic realization and cosmic revelation. Is it clear? Is it clear? So cosmic revelation is always active. Somebody else has given to you. This source is outside. But in self-realization, this source is inside. You understand, Arvind? So this is the case. Now this is called tatva-jnana. In Sanskrit, if I use, it is called, and this is direct perception. He perceived it. What you can't see, Einstein directly saw reality, scientific reality. So that is called pratyaksha. Tatva pratyaksha. He had direct realization with his eyes, closed eyes or open eyes. If it is closed eye, the third eye always remains open. Even if you keep your eyes closed, the third eye always sees something. And if you keep open, so third eye is always open. So cosmic realization or individual realization is related to that reality which is seen by this, and it is called pratyaksha pramana, pratyaksha. Aksha means eyes. So direct perception means you see that the reality, your observer, your observing process, observation, and what observed, what you have observed. So it is called jnata, jnaya and jnana in Sanskrit. Or knower, knowledge, knower, process of knowing and what is to be known. This is called trinity, triple. So this is, it is called pratyaksha jnana. And pratyaksha jnana needs no other proof. It is self-evident, self-same and self-dependent. But after that you may again have to establish that. Then again you require some kind of proof. Proof or what you call validity or evaluation. Then that becomes indirect. So for direct perception, direct knowledge, you don't require any proof. But after that, it becomes indirect. And therefore, you have to have inference, implication, indication, or any other means of validity of knowledge. So first is tattva pratyaksha. He had tattva pratyaksha, pratyaksha jnana. But after that, what is to be done? Knowledge itself can't do anything. So it has to be brought down from higher level to lower level. And that is called Atma-jnana. Tattva-jnana is already there, but you have realized, he has realized. So each individual will be having one's own realization. So Atma-jnana. So relativity Einstein had is Atma-jnana. So Atma-jnana is always subjective. Self-realization is subjective. And self-revelation is objective. So this we should understand. Now we are coming down. So he has Atmajnana. First was Tattvajnana. On individual level it is slightly brought down. Therefore it is Atmajnana. But after Jnana, after Atmajnana, it must become Mantra Jnana. You must know the crux of it. Crux. In short. So that is called Mantra Jnana. Mantra Jnana means, just as Tilak used to say, freedom is my own right. Or information is my own right. So it is like a mantra. Or Swachha Bharat, as we say today. Or Vande Maharam. These are mantras. So what it means that mantra is, it gives some sanctity to that. It is a, in short, it is a sanctity. And it is a sacred thing. Mantra here means, it gives in brief. It changes the whole personality. So just as Gandhi used to say, non-cooperation. It was a mantra in those days. So that mantra is a small, but it contains the seed of all, everything you are going to have later on. So it is called Mantra Jnana. So first was Tantra Jnana, then Atma Jnana, then Mantra Jnana. And mantra always is at the background, working at the background. Mantra is said to be that which already gets embedded into the very mind of the person. And it is always at the back. Just as we see computer movie here and there, computer, but always at the back there is a power, off and on. So without our knowledge, that power is already there. It is so much that we forget that it is because of power that computer is running. So this Atma Jnana, then Mantra Jnana, but Mantra Jnana will not get, it must get concretized from abstract. It must get concrete. Then we have to have some kind of Ganita Jnana, some kind of mathematical formula you have to prepare. And for that you must have compactness. It is called Sutra Jnana. So first Tattva Jnana, then Atma Jnana, then Mantra Jnana, then Ganita Jnana, mathematical representation of the reality. And that too not very big. Sutra Jnana in a compact form, sutra, compact form, thread. A thread, if you know the thread, then you can stretch it and you can prepare any sort of cloth or etc. So sutra means generative thread, generative just as DNA, RNA. So you must formulate your knowledge in such a way that as if you are giving some kind of formula, some kind of equations, and very compact. Descriptive is Sutra Jnana. For example, when I say energy is equal to mass and C square, this is descriptive, therefore it is sutra. But it is not a formula. E is equal to mc square is the formula. So it is like a compactification of knowledge called is Sutra Jnana. But that is based on Ganita Jnana. So Sutra Jnana, after Sutra Jnana, you must have some kind of prayoga, experiments. And for that experiments, you must have some kind of controlling system, some kind of step by step, what you call bar star probably, or what is that?
Flow chart,
bar star, all those things. So you must have step by step. That abstract thing must come down here step by step.
Flow chart.
So this Sutra Jnana is over based on Ganita Jnana. Ganita Jnana indicates also what we call arithmetics, mathematics and geometry. Akar also, the volume also, and the size and shape. Circular, triangular, rectangular, cylindrical, all those things. So all this is covered under Ganita Jnana. But it is still conceptual. It is not yet put into black and white or what you call blueprint. It is still there. But so Sutra Jnana means compactness. And so, why this is so? Because it is very easy to learn mantra. It is very easy to learn by heart sutras. So entropy, description of entropy or description of momentum or description of gravity, everyone has its own some kind of symbol. And once you know the equation, if you know the compact formulation, then it is very easy to learn by heart. And it always works at the background. It always remains there. So this is very important. And therefore, so that sutra, then prayoga means experiment. And for that you use kind of control system, and it is called yantra. Prayoga jnana, then yantra jnana. Means yantra is from the root yama to control. Total control system from A to Z. And then you can start prayoga, experiment, not otherwise. So this is yantra, is therefore this root yama means to control. So from the same root you get yama means yantra, or control, or total coordination. Everything is required there. So yantra jnana. And then what is the use of this experiments and controlling system? Then you must start tantra jnana. You must have, you know, prayoga and control system first is not on large scale. It is just the laboratory. So prayoga is basically only in laboratory, confined to the small area, limited area. And once it is successful there, so it is small product, prototype is prepared and it is successful. Then once it is established, then it needs to be large scale application, objective, large scale. And therefore it is called technology or tantra jnana. Tantra also has a meaning. Tantra is from the same root tana, means to stretch, to weaving. And tantra means fabricated body. And secondary meaning is technology. Once you know that, then you just go on repeating it, objective. So tantra jnana means it is now going from individual level to market, from small to large scale application, large scale production, and large scale usage. So that is tantra jnana, technology. Only when you come to the level of technology, it is of no use. Otherwise it is only small scale, it is only experimental, it is only laboratories, not yet, unless it is successful outside, its success is judged not in the laboratory, but outside the laboratory.
In use.
So it is called prayoga jnana. Prayoga jnana is over, yantra jnana is over, tantra jnana is also over. But ultimately, only technical people will be able to understand and operate that. But what about common man? So it must be also vyavahara jnana. Vyavahara, it should be commercial level. For a common man also, just now I just put on the button, I am using this. So this is called vyavahara jnana. So first we have started with tattva jnana, tattva pratyaksha, atma pratyaksha, ganita pratyaksha, yantra pratyaksha, prayoga pratyaksha, tantra pratyaksha, and prayoga pratyaksha. And all this put together is shastra pratyaksha. All this is shastra. So this is, and it is not only temporary, but related to, it was done only once, but what about next? So it must be eternally, perpetually upgraded and grown up. So growth and development. So it is not now confined to small area, but it is beyond what we call space, time and region. Space, time and climb. Not only here, anywhere, in any situation. So all this means shastra jnana. This is what we call paradigm approach. What is called approach? This approach is now you will find everywhere. Suppose now in that case, Leo said relativity. In quantum mechanics, the reality is quite different. So but this process and this paradigm is the same. If you go to religion say my aim is to go to God, then instead of saying this realization, Deva Pratyaksha, Deva, I want to God realization. But I can't have God realization, but I can have God revelation. Somebody has given me, so I got God. I saw the God. Then what is it? Then you have prepared some mantra, you are giving to mantra, that some people will get peace and so. So what is the aim and object? Aim and object is go from particular or individual to total. From what we call, from local to global.